Can you tell who the host is? Like, honestly, that was it the entire game. Ridiculous. What is up? It is Brock, aka Tony Wonder, and this is going to be the last Black Ops game that I post before Modern Warfare 3 comes out. It's about damn time. So excited for this game. I actually just found out some pretty bad news, though. Not bad for any of you, but it's bad for me. I found out I have to go out of town on work, on a little business trip. And I have to leave on the 9th. So basically, I am going to the midnight release of on the 8th, playing all through the night and day, and then going on a little absence for, I don't know, 5 days or a week or something like that, and I'm just basically going to be thinking about the game the whole time. It's going to be torture. I'm just going to have to watch some YouTube videos and kind of figure out the maps from that so I don't get stuck too far behind. You know, gotta get up on the map knowledge for the Christmas noobs, you know what I'm saying? Before I get into anything else, I just wanted to give a little bit of an apology of sorts. I feel like my last couple of videos I've done nothing but bitch about what I'm expecting in Modern Warfare 3, and I don't want to come off like that kind of guy. I really love Call of Duty, and I'm expecting a lot from Modern Warfare 3. Maybe that's too much to ask, but once again, I'm sorry. Give me a chance if I've put you off. Now that that's taken care of, I'm gonna be finishing the injury series. Kind of took a break from it. This is probably one of the weirdest injuries I had. This was after I retired from rugby the first time, when I dislocated my elbow. And I had taken kind of a couple, like a, I don't know, 2 year break from rugby. And I missed it too much. I missed the competition too much. Started playing again, and I started playing with the community college team that I was going to. And it was just really bush league, and we practiced on this horrible field in this park. And, like, I mean, we found a couple of used needles and stuff like that on the field, but we didn't have anywhere else to practice. So I had played, like, one game, and then we were just doing a little inter-squad scrimmage, and the ball got kicked off, and I took off for the ball, and I caught it, but right when I caught it, I put my foot in a pothole, and I just heard this loud pop, and all of a sudden I just realized I was down on the ground. And honestly, it looked like a sniper got me. Like, all of a sudden I was just down and no one knew what happened because I was kind of far away from everyone, and started my usual cursing that I do when I get hurt, and had to go to the hospital, get a MRI and all of that fun stuff. That, look at this guy, I should have gotten killed right here. I'll take the kill. But that was the first time that I was really concerned with what was going on with my future in sports, and I kind of took a break from sports after that. But on the bright side, when I got home from my surgery, I found that my cousin had let me borrow his Xbox, and I started playing this game called Call of Duty 4 and got really into it. I only was really playing the campaign, but that's the first time that I played Call of Duty, and I played it for, like, I don't know, 2-3 months straight, and I fell in love with it. And that's what really got me into video games, and I realized that I was going to be addicted to it if I had my own Xbox, and I tried to put it off, but yeah, about a year ago I bought an Xbox, and I've been playing on it ever since, and it's a great purchase. That's going to do it for the injury series. I'm going to put this in a playlist and I really hope you enjoyed it. Can't wait for Modern Warfare 3. Gonna end this with the best clip I ever had in Black Ops. Really appreciate you watching. Peace.